video. Today I'll be telling you how to be a ballerina. Okay, so first off, to be a dancer, you have to dance, like, a lot.
You actually do need to dance quite a lot to be the ballerina, because you need to keep in shape and you need to keep improving. And that means times like winter break, it can be really hard on a dancer's body, especially if you have to go right back into it. So, well, 2 week periods aren't that big of a deal. A break like the summer, you're definitely going to be dancing through that if you really want to keep up a high level of danceability.
If you want to be a ballet dancer, you definitely have to know how to do buns, and that means the ballerina buns and the messy buns.
This one's only slightly true. It is not required for you to know how to do a messy bun to be a ballerina. I definitely don't, but it is much preferred by all teachers if you know how to do a proper bun and you can do it, especially because you need them for competition. It stays in better in class and it looks more professional. So you definitely need to know how to do a bun. Messy bun, not so much.
To be a ballerina, you need to wear leggings all the time.
No, this one's not true because I definitely don't wear leggings all the time. Most dancers will tend to wear leggings as it will allow them to feel as though they still have as much movement as they do while dancing. However, it is not required to be a ballerina that you need to wear leggings all the time. I often wear jeans, and that is totally fine with me. I feel like I have just as much movement, and it's really personal preference, not whether or not you're a dancer.
You really need to watch what you're eating if you want to be a proper dancer.
Well, this one is actually kind of true. You do need to watch what you're putting in your body. You need to make sure that you're getting enough protein and energy, and you need to make sure you're giving enough energy as you're dancing so you don't wear out. You need to keep eating and you need to give yourself healthy food so you have the proper energy. But at the same time, it's not like you're gonna be, oh my gosh, I need a diet. It's fine to do whatever to eat crappy food every once in a while, especially if you need that burst of energy. Short sugars are totally fine to eat. Especially if your blood sugar's low after you dance a bit, or you need those electrolytes, or whatever you want. You don't need to meticulously watch what you're eating. On top of eating healthy, you do need to drink a lot of water, because the last thing you really want is a dehydrated body. The one thing you do have to watch is make sure you're not drinking too much water, or you'll wash all the electrolytes out of your body. Especially, this happens a lot, especially if you've been dancing for a long time, like summer camps. I've done a summer camp where I was dancing for 6 hours a day, and I was drinking a lot of water, and I definitely had a really low depletion of electrolytes by the second or third day, but that's when stuff like Gatorade or other sports drinks actually come.
Finally, you need to watch all the dance shows to be able to be a dancer.
Now, well, this one's not true, it can actually be very helpful. By watching the dance shows, you can see other people's choreography and you get to look into the world of professional dancers, especially if you want to, or you are considering looking into a career in dance. You get to see how other people choreograph and it will help you with your own choreography as well. Now, while these don't have teasing stereotypes, these next facts are also very important in being a ballerina. You need to constantly stretch. That may sound like a really daunting task, but it can keep your muscles warm, stretched out, they won't tighten up, and it can reduce risk of injury, especially if you have danced for a while. It's always good to stretch before and to keep stretching to make sure your muscles don't get too tight and then you end up pushing it. Speaking of injuries, it is very important that when you have an injury, you have to rest it. Dancing on an injury will not help it get better, it can actually make it worse. So you need to know when it's just a little tweak and you can keep going, and when you do need to sit out and stop. And finally, you need to sleep. Dancers need time to recuperate their bodies. You will push your bodies to their limits. That's basically one of the points of dance, is to see how far you can go. But with all the constant pushing of your body, you cannot just demand, 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 or it will break. You need to let your body rest. So sleep is a very big thing.
Well, that's it for this video. Thank you all for watching. Make sure you click the thumbs up button if you like it, and don't forget to subscribe down below. Next week, my video will have a few extra guests in it, so make sure you stay tuned for that. Don't forget to check out my blog and subscribe if you like it. Bye.